Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to have you here today. It's good to see each of you out with us this morning. And this is by far my most favorite way to start a service off is with a baptism. And we are honored today to have Chris Wilmot come this morning. And we were just talking back there. Really, Chris started coming to our church several years ago, all because of a wrong turn. And they were on their way to another church that morning and turned the wrong way off the highway and drove down here looking for a place to turn around. And they, oh, there's a driveway up here. We'll turn around there. And it was our church. They said, well, we're not going to make it to the other one in time. Let's just go there. And that's where they started coming. And I told Chris we can't get rid of them now. And so, what a blessing it's been. Got to do discipleship with Chris several years ago. We went to Bible studies together. And of course, about almost 2 years ago, Chris was diagnosed with cancer and had a very serious surgery where the cancer was removed. And that caused some physical problems that delayed this. This is really something Chris wanted to do from about 2 years ago, but he needed that healing in his in that middle part of his body, there, his abdomen, to heal not just externally but internally, so we could do the physical act. But really, I think this was 2 years ago. Chris did this in his heart.
Yeah.
And he wanted to follow the Lord at believer's baptism. So I want Chris to share his testimony with you, and then after his baptism, he has requested to join our church. And so I'm going to have Chris share his testimony.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I come before you today just as I am. I would like to share how I arrived at this momentous proclamation of my obedience to the Word. Both my parents were involved in church whenever we moved, and each time we moved, it was the same mission to find a place to worship. Our Savior has always been working on me. From my grandfather teaching me the Lord's Prayer to a recent interaction with a child from my neighborhood, my faith stands on 2 Corinthians 5:8. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be present from the body and to be present with the Lord. He is always with me and has heard me when I cried out to him. On a day in April 1993, I attended a church with a friend from college. Soon after the welcome, I realized that this was not a place of worship that was typical of the Bible-centered teaching I was used to receiving. Right there in the pew, I asked Jesus to save me, to enter my heart and to save me from this world and my sin. A feeling came over me much like a comfort, and any distress I had was alleviated. It was in this moment that I fully gave my life over to God. There was no fight, only a submission to His will. I now want to proclaim publicly by my baptism that I am a true follower our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Chris and I were talking about this the other day. We had this foundation of years in church, and then we went to the wrong kind of church with a friend who was invited. It didn't. God used that negative to bring him to the point where I need to give my heart to the Lord right here and right now. And he was giving that testimony. So that's a pretty amazing thing, how the Lord used a negative situation. But from those years of foundational teachings, he knew what he needed to do, and he called on the Lord that day to save him. Praise the Lord for him. So you rejoice with us now as we see Chris follow the Lord in the Lord's example. Again, we do not believe baptism has anything to do with one's salvation, but completely in obedience to the Lord's command and to the Lord's example of being baptized by immersion. And so you rejoice with us as we do this.
Chris, based upon your profession of your faith in Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, I now baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Buried in the likeness of his death, raised again to walk in newness of life.
Amen. Amen.
So if you're a member here today, and you have heard Chris's testimony, you have seen his baptism, and you would like to vote him into the membership of Capital City Baptist Church, let it be known by a good hearty amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Welcome to the family, brother.
Amen. Amen.